Hey, what's up, guys? I just gave away my salary at the University of Ibadan to people asking programming questions. And apparently, these people are super smart. And somebody even won 5,000 naira, which was way, way out of budget. So, my name is Arimu.
I'm at Kidir.
Johnson.
My name is Peter.
So what language do you write?
JavaScript.
Nice.
Wow!
We're in the ghetto together. Did you write React?
Yeah, I do.
You say you know Python. Are there floating point numbers in Python?
Yes.
And there are integers. So, what's the difference between floating point numbers and integers?
Well, floating point numbers do not have decimal points.
Anyway?
Sorry, floating point numbers have decimal points, while integers do not have decimal points.
Can you mention five hooks in React?
Okay. Use effect. Use state. Use layout effect. Use memo. Use ref.
Use ref. Correct. Do you know the origin of the, like, why strings are called string?
I don't know the origin of why strings are called string. So,
this bitch, she trying to fame, she's on my neck. Viewers, apologize, I'm continue.
That's why, like, the is actually a very good thing for, like, when you're doing programming interviews. Like, if you don't know something, just say you don't know it. So, the origin of strings is because they say, like, the way computers store string is like the way you arrange bits on a string. So that's why they call them string. In programming, okay. What is called, do you know what is called syntactic sugar in programming?
Anyway?
Syntactic what?
Syntactic sugar.
Sugar?
Syntactic sugar.
That's, hold up.
Hey, I'll come look at this.
Should I help you out?
Actually, that concept, I don't understand. It sounds all different from bad luck.
Yeah.
What you just used to
explain.
That's what I'm trying to, you know, put together and, you know.
Right. Well, let me just help you. Just
am I still getting
that? Yeah, getting one more question. Syntactic sugar in programming is just basically approaches to make your code much human readable. Have you heard of fizz buzz before? Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
Okay, cool.
Okay.
So if you have, like, let's say a range of numbers, let's say 1 to 100, right? If you look through the number, if the number is divisible by 3, okay, you console log fizz to the screen. If it's divisible by 5, you console log buzz to the screen. If it's divisible by the 2 of them, you console log fizz buzz to the screen. Okay. You want to give it a shot? Oh yeah, now.
If you put it in an array, that would be too large in this use case. So you can just put it in a,
you can just do a for loop or while loop or any loop you are comfortable with.
All right, let's go.
So yeah, so what's the difference between, there is difference between, I think, list and tuple.
Like,
the difference between list and tuple is that tuples are fixed objects. Any item stored in a tuple cannot be reassigned.
Wow!
But for list, you can reassign any object or any item.
Mutable.
Yes, immutable.
Hmm. I want this guy. I want to chop this to in JavaScript. Yeah. So, how would you submit a form? Like, how would you prevent a form from refreshing the page or submitting?
When I say asynchronous JavaScript, is that weird?
That has no board and transmogrify.
That's a concept. Oh yeah, Epi.
You, if it's in React, you create a function. You basically have the function. Or on the form, you can have a function and you have an event that is tapping into the target. Then if you print the default, that it does prevent the default.
Exactly, so that's what you do. So the form itself has events, and part of the things that the events can do is to prevent the default action. So it does prevent the default. Okay.
So we can say, this should work.
Okay. Your solution works actually, but there's a problem. I'll tell you the problem, maybe you can fix it. So right now, so you are checking if 3 is divisible by 3, then you are printing fizz. That would work. So if the first number is 3, for example, right, it's going to print fizz. Else, if it's divisible by 5, it's not divisible by 5, so of course it does not concern, so that will pass. Now, for a number like 15, if it's divisible by 3 and 5, print this bus. Now, because this is an else if. Now, if, for example, I use an example of 15. When is divisible by 3?
That 15 now. It is divisible by 3 and also 5. So, it shouldn't print fees separately and bus separately. It should only print fees bus.
Yeah, so basically, the last line is not needed. The last line, because if a number is already divisible by 3,
it's going to else. You don't even need to.
Okay, yeah, then you can just say else. Consider log fees bus. Or another approach you can take is just say let message equals something, so maybe an empty string. So if it's divisible by 3, you store the fees inside the message. If it's divisible by bus, you store the message. So once the two is true, it's going to be fees bus. But your solution was correct. I'm still going to give it to you. Thank you.
Yeah. Okay, so now here, now this code now here, it will work for that 15.
It won't.
This LEB here.
I get coconut head.
No, it won't. Okay. Because the first condition is
our mess.
Okay, I understand now.
I'm helping you out
Okay. Let's go easy.
Do you know array methods in JavaScript?
A little bit.
Can you mention 5 array methods in JavaScript?
No.
Do you know what objects are in JavaScript?
Yes, sir.
So how do you get all the keys of an object in JavaScript?
To pick it out.
Huh?
To pick it out, right?
Yeah, just the keys alone. And put them in an array.
The name of the object dot that property or the key you want to pick out.
No, like all the keys. So let's say you have an object that has like 1 million keys. Okay, yeah. Let's say human being, you know, you have different methods, you have different properties. So how do you pick all the keys in that object and put it in an array?
Well, you create an array, and then you just insert the object into it.
That's mechanic work. I thought everybody wanted to be a baller this year. Mention 5 frameworks and 5 libraries across any programming language and stuff.
One, Django is a framework. Flask in Python is a framework. React is a library.
Framework, we have Django, we have Flask, Kinta.
Mugbe will land the cap.
Yes.
What's that used for?
It's used for GUI.
Next.
Next, yes.
The library too.
No. Next, yes, it is.
We do keep quiet.
Next.js is not a library.
Oh, okay. Can you tell me why?
Next.js is a framework.
How is it a framework?
I get coconut head.
Next.js gives you everything you need outside of the box. Routing. You can add things on top of it, but it is a library. It is a framework. It is a framework.
Okay, across any...
Yeah, it doesn't have to be Python.
Okay.
I don't like it, all those... No, I like Jelly Raw, you know? I like Jelly Raw.
We have NumPy. We have Pandas. We have Scikit-learn. SciPy.
He told you now. but you know you don't have the entire 5K, eh?
I have it.
No.
I get them.
No, you didn't get all the questions now.
Which one?
Framework, we have Keras, TensorFlow.
Is TensorFlow a framework or a library? Is it a framework or a library? TensorFlow.
TensorFlow is a framework now.
Are you sure it's a framework?
TensorFlow is used for deep learning.
Okay, for I need to clear this.
No problem. So okay, yeah. So then that means one library to go.
Yeah, I'm getting my 5K. Come on. Wait, so okay. Don't put tension on me. I know it, but you think the one library. Okay, beautiful soup.
Soft.
Well, this should work.
I think this works.
Oh, I'm correct.
Yeah. 5K.
My name is Ahmad, and right here, right now, here, I just won 5,000 naira on programming. you know.
So if you like this kind of content, please kindly like, share, and of course subscribe to the channel in order to support us. Drop your comments in the comment section and let us know what you think about the video. And if you are a brand that you like to sponsor this kind of video, please reach out to us at webbossafrica@gmail.com. Cheers, and don't forget to be like the boss.
Give this guy right from there, maybe
IG, I got you.